Hey, what's up, guys? So we're back in Street Fighter Cross Tekken with some online matches here. So during these videos, I wanted to go over the topic of Evo Championship Series or Evolution Championship Series. So for those of you guys who don't know what this is an annual big like American fighting game tournament. It's like a big gathering of different fighting games in like one big area. So they always have it in Las Vegas around this time in the summer. This year it's from July 6th to July 8th. So this year the lineup for games that they have are Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition. They have Ultimate Marvel Capcom 3, Street Fighter Cross Tekken, Soul Calibur 5, Mortal Kombat, King of Fighters 13, and Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo. So they actually have a very big payout this year for the winners, really. I think it's the biggest they've had so far in any Evo tournament to date. So what I wanted to go over with Evo is, are you guys looking forward to Evo Championship Series, if you guys even watch it at all? If you guys have never even watched any tournament footage, this is a great time to check it out because it's only a few days away and the excitement and the hype is really intense in this. I started watching Evo when they were streaming in 2009, back when Street Fighter 4 came out. And I remember the grand finals in Street Fighter 4 was Daigo from Japan and Justin Wong in America. Daigo was using Ryu and Justin was using Balrog. And in Super Street Fighter 4, I can't recall who was in the finals with Daigo. I don't remember. It's been a while. But in Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition for Evo 2011, I know the grand finals were between Fudo, who was using Fei Long, and Latif, who was using Sea Viper. And out of all three Evo grand finals, they are all really hyped. They are really hyped. There's a lot of intense moments and situations when players have to make critical thinking and critical movements, have precise inputs on all their moves. It's one of those tournaments that are really big and can really get you into fighting games if you guys have never even seen any at all. They're going to be having it from this weekend, from Friday the 6th to Sunday the 8th. And I'm not going to be able to catch everything, but I'm going to try to catch as much as I can when they cover AE and Street Fighter Cross Tekken. Even though Street Fighter 4 has been a very big hyped game since it came out, especially for tournaments, along with Marvel vs. Capcom 3 and, the new one that came out, Ultimate Marvel 3. Even though those two are the biggest games, I'm still looking more forward to Street Fighter Cross Tekken. Oddly enough, I know the game has gotten a bad rap and it's kind of losing its steam because, people just aren't really talking about it too much. I guess maybe it didn't pick up to where Street Fighter 4 kind of left off because, it's got similar mechanics but different things in general that kind of make it a different game. But there's some similar things you can apply to it, really. Like, for example, the combo potential is, I think, a bit higher in this game compared to Street Fighter 4. But anyways, I'm really interested in seeing who's, going to be teaming up for the 2-on-2 Street Fighter Cross Tekken tournament scene there. So, I know they're going to have gems disabled, which is perfectly fine, Ultimate Marvel 3, I don't think I'm going to watch too much of it. I'll probably watch big matches like with well-known players, and that's about it. Mortal Kombat, I'm probably not gonna watch that much. Between Mortal Kombat and Soul Calibur, I'm probably gonna be watching those two the least, probably. Simply because they're games that just don't really interest me that much, but I don't mind watching some of the matches, especially with very well-known players. Now for Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, I don't know if they're gonna get that streamed. Because what happened last year was they were only really streaming the big games, and we didn't get that much Super Turbo on stream. So, I don't know what's going to go on with that. I think they're going to run two or three streams, something like that. I guess one for maybe AE and Marvel, one for Mortal Kombat and Soul Calibur, and maybe a third one for like, you know, smaller games like Super Turbo or Skullgirls or something else on the side. I don't know. But we'll see what happens. But, you know, I wanted to ask you guys if you even watch any tournament footage or tournament streams at all, or even Evo. What do you guys think of the tournament scene, of what's going on? So aside from that, I'm really curious to see what characters are going to be used in Top 8 in Arcade Edition and in Street Fighter Cross Tekken, and what players will make it to Top 8. Especially for Street Fighter Cross Tekken, because it's still, you know, a fairly new game, so it's going to be the first tournament from EVO with this game. So I want to see, you know, what kind of roster is going to make it to top 8. You know, I'm just throwing this out. I'm kind of thinking top 8 for the roster of the game characters will probably be a mix of like Ryu, Kazuya, Rolento, those are the three. I think those three are like the main ones I think are going to be either in top 8 or the most used. But we'll see how that goes, really. But I'm also interested in seeing about the top 8 in Street Fighter Cross Tekken and in Arcade Edition. I'm interested in seeing how many international players will make it to the top 8 spots in either games. I don't know if the international players are even taking Street Fighter Cross Tekken seriously for this tournament, or if they're just going to be focusing on like Marvel 3 or Super Turbo or Arcade Edition. So that's one thing I'm wondering also, because, you know, it's a game that didn't really get such a really positive look from the fighting game community because of all the issues it had at the beginning and the current issues it's still going through, you know. But we'll see what Capcom does with this game, because I really like this game, and, you know, there's just minor issues, but, you know, there's always little things in all the games you'll find annoying. But, you know, it's either they'll eventually patch it or they won't, and, you know, they're going to drop support for the game, and then that's pretty much what you have to deal with, you know. Something that, you know, is annoying you so much in the game that just you have to overlook or just move on, pretty much, you know. So I'm really wondering what's going to happen in Street Fighter Cross Tekken. I'm wondering if Rufus is still going to be just as good, you know, since he got nerfed after the last patch for this dive kick there, along with Jury as well. I'm wondering how they're going to play out. So, I mean, I want to know also from you guys, if you guys are into Marvel, Mortal Kombat, Soul Calibur, Street Fighter Cross Tekken, Super Turbo, Street Fighter 4, pretty much. Who do you think, as in the players, Who do you guys think is going to make it into top 8 into each game, or just the game that you're interested in? And what characters do you think they're going to use? Also, I want to also change the topic over to Marvel 3, well, Ultimate Marvel 3. Now, I've watched a few tournaments that have actually been held before EVO in the past 2 months, and it seems that some players are more effective with a specific team. But when it comes to smaller tournaments that don't have such a big payout or are just for fun, you know, just for streaming casual matches, it seems they're not using their perfect team. They're more likely going to a different team just for the casual matches that are going on stream or YouTube. And it seems like they're going to hold their best team for EVO. That's what it looks like. So I guess we'll see what goes on there. But as for Marvel, you know, I noticed that ever since Ultimate came out, there's been a drop of, what's his name? Dante. Yeah, Dante players have been kind of like steadily dropping him for different characters, I guess. Because he was used a lot, I noticed. He's got like really insane combos, and with his wide range of special moves that he can do, it's really nuts. But I've noticed that people drop Dante in exchange for Virgil. And Virgil does seem like a much better character when you compare the two, especially with the spinning sword super move that he has that can really combo into like normal moves and chain combos and stuff like that. But we'll see how that goes too. You know, I don't see Sentinel as much as I used to, like in Marvel 3 when he had like tons of health and that super armor kick that he has and the low kick. It seems Sentinel is fine these days, really. He really seems fine. I know that Dark Phoenix got a nerf also. She has like less health, so she'll die in one simple combo also. But I still think she's a threat, because when she turns into Dark Phoenix, she has like these crazy, you know, expanded moves that do a bit more hits done or something, or have bigger priority, like a bigger hitbox, faster speed, you know, stuff like that. So I guess we'll see how that goes. I'm wondering if there's going to be like one of those situations when one character or one player actually pulls out like this really random team that no one has seen before, and they pull out some really good strategies, and it seems to be like super effective because like no one has seen it yet. But you know, I guess we'll see how it goes. But yeah, I'm gonna be watching EVO July 6th to July 8th, and for those of you guys who haven't watched any, I urge you guys, check it out when it happens this weekend. I promise you, it's going to be exciting, as it always is every year. It's really nuts. Anyways, guys, this is Azaglow. I'm going to sign off for now. I'm going to catch you guys later on. See you.